Hey everyone. So in our last video, I showed you how to connect up ClickUp via Zapier to HubSpot so that when there's a task change in ClickUp, like this, when we change one of these contacts that we've saved in this task list in ClickUp, when we change the status to confirmed, it's going to automatically create a deal in HubSpot like this. The only downside of this is that it doesn't automatically connect up the different objects, the contact and the company to this deal. It only creates a brand new deal with a name here like this, but it won't create the relationships or the associations between the deal object and the contacts and companies. So I want to show you how you can also do that with Zapier as well. So basically you've got this simple Zap that we started with in the last video. So please feel free to start by checking that video out. And then once we've got this deal set up, we can then create the associations that we need. So we add another task step and we find the standard HubSpot integration here. And then we're going to do a search and we need to create the associations between the different areas. So we're going to add create association. We can skip this task halting strategy. That's fine. Halt task if at least one association is not created. And then the ID of the object being associated. So as you can see here, we need the ID of the contact of the company in HubSpot. And at the moment, we don't have that in this flow. So we need to have another step before this create association where we find the ID. And so we're going to scroll down to the find section. And we want to find contact first. This, and we're going to search for the email address because we've got that detail. So we scroll down to email. There's a lot of properties that come through from HubSpot, so it can be kind of hard to find the email sometimes. You're looking for the gray text which says email, and you've got to make sure it's not the wrong property. Like this is a Facebook ads property with work email, so you can ignore that for what we need here. It should be just very simple, just like this contact information email. That's what we need. And then we're going to type in, or we're going to relate it to that ClickUp step where we have that email address. So let's do a search for that email. And again, you've got to be careful to select the right property. You can see here, these are internal my email address. This is not what we want. We want the email address of the custom field that we've set up. So this is the contact's email address here, like this. And that's it for the contact search section. We don't want to get any other properties, so we can skip all these other steps. Click continue. We test the step. Great. So we pulled in his detail. This is the ID. And then we also want the company association as well. So I'm going to add another step here. Company. We're going to do a search with the company name. Actually, it can be a bit dangerous to choose company name because the detail we have for the contact, if we go to his contact details here, we can see that the company name under his property, under the contact object, the company name is like this. But like, let's say that he typed in, when he filled in a form, he typed in like Star Alliance Australia or something like that. And so that's the company name that's under his contact. That's what he's typed in maybe to a form or something like that. But the way that HubSpot has created the company here that's associated with him is it's used his domain in the email address to associate him with the global sort of head office. And this is the object. This is a company object. So I've done another video explaining objects, so I'll link to that above as well, because that's a little bit complicated if you're not familiar with this, the structure of CRMs. So there's an association with this global object, the company, based on the domain, which is different than the detail that we've got under his particular record here. So we actually, rather than doing a search for the company name, because that could come up instead, it might come up with this company name that we can see for him under his title here. I'm going to throw that in the contact view so we can see it here. Yeah, so there you see this is the name that he's written in here, and then this is the global name. So we don't want to use the company name to search for that. Instead, we want to use the domain, which is a safer way to find it. And so we're going to instead grab the domain. So to do that, we're going to type in company domain. And actually, oh, here it is. Yep. And so it's actually called domain under the company object, but you can see here that the full name here is, says company domain name. So we can select that. And then we can then put the domain in here. But let's see if we have his domain. So yes, so when we did the find contact step here, we've actually been able to pull the domain, which is already saved under his contact here. So we can then use that here to find the company in HubSpot so that we get the company ID number. And so let's continue. Let's test this step. Okay, that's great. And then let's click continue again. And now we can create the associations. So we want to add a deal object ID here. So let's find the deal ID like this. And we're going to say deal. And then we're going to associate this with two other objects, the contact and the company. And so we say contact like this. And we add the contact ID. We select the association, deal to contact. Yep. And then we add the ID. Custom contact ID, record ID like that. And then we add in second object is the company. And we say the association is deal to company. And then we need the company. Oh, we go to custom. There we go. Company ID like this. And we find the record. Here we go. We got our record ID. Now we click continue, test step. And then let's have a look at this contact. Let me refresh him. And now we should be able to see, yep, the deal. There we go. The deal is now associated to that contact and the deal is associated to the company. So now the last thing we need to do is just publish that. And then that's basically it. So give that a shot. Let me know what you think. And if you have any questions, feel free to add comments below. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.